sucks. Come on, man, jobs don't get much weirder than this, you know? Dead Vic with a knot on neck, body drained of blood, and a witness who swears up and down that it was a vampire.
No, I agree, it's a hell of a case.
Yeah, up in Standing, Pennsylvania, the poltergeist thing. It's not back, is it?
No. No. Thank God. But it's something else.
What is it?
Can we talk in person?
call Bella.
Bella? Yeah.
What she said? She gonna help us?
Shockingly, no.
Thank you. morning when you told me about the dark's experiments, I was all starting to make a hell of a lot more sense.
How so?
This plant, Selene capensis, also known as African dream root, has been used by shaman and medicine men for centuries.
Let me guess, it dose up, bust out the didgeridoos, and start kicking around the hacky?
Not quite. If you believe the legends, it's used for dream work. Entering another person's dreams, poking around their heads.
I take it we believe the legends.
When dealt with.
Dreamwalking is just the tip of the iceberg.
What do you mean?
I mean, this dream root is some serious mojo. You take enough of it with enough practice, you can become a regular Freddy Krueger. You can control anything. You can turn bad dreams good. You can turn good dreams bad.
From killing people in their sleep.
For example? So let's say this doc was testing the stuff on his patients, Tim Weary style.
Somebody gets pissed at him, decides to give him a little dream visit. He goes night and night.
So, is that right?
Is it the serial killing chimney sweep?
Yep. It's actually Dick Van Dyke.
Who?
Mary Poppins.
Who's that?
Oh, come on.
Turns out that Walsh is the second guy in town grabbed out of his house this month.
Yeah?
Yeah. Glad the guy got dragged up the chimney, too.
Don't know. Witnesses said they heard a thump on the roof. So what the hell do you think we're dealing with?
Actually, I have an idea.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's gonna sound crazy.
What you possibly said it sounds crazy.
Evil Santa.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I mean, I'm just saying that there's some version of the Anti-Claus. In every culture, you got Belsnickel, Krampus, Black Peter, whatever you want to call it, there's all sorts of lore.
Saying what?
Saying back in the day, Santa's brother went rogue, and now he shows up around Christmas time, but instead of bringing presents, he punishes the wicked.
By hauling their ass up chimneys?
For starters, yeah.
So this is your theory, huh? Santa's shady brother?
Just saying, that's what the lore says.
Santa doesn't have a brother. There is no Santa.
Yeah, I know. You're the one who told me that in the first place, remember?
Turns out both victims visited the same place before they got snatched. Reeds, huh? Sure didn't want to ask for better shoes. I saw some nice handbags in the foyer.
We've seen that Reeds before, Dean.
Where?
The Walshes. Yesterday.
I know. I was just testing you.
No, you're right. It's definitely weird. Okay, Bobby. Thanks.
What's up?
Bobby found something in Wyoming.
Job?
Maybe. Small town, no one's died in the past week and a half.
That's so unusual?
Well, that's how they not die. One guy with terminal cancer strolls right out of hospice. Another guy gets capped by a mugger, walks away without a scratch.
Capped in the ash?
Police say Mr. Jenkins was shot in the heart at point-blank range by a 9mm.
He's not a donut?
Locals are saying it's a miracle.
Okay.
Gotta be something nasty back. Like deals or something?
Okay.
What else would it be?
I don't know. Sure you want me going with you?
Why wouldn't I?
I don't want to be holding you back.
Dude, I've told you 100 times that was the siren talking, not me. Can we get past this?
Yeah, we're past it.
Found a job. Bedford, Iowa. Guy beat his wife's brains out with meat tenderizer.
Yikes.
Now get this. Third local inside 2 months to gain his wife. No prior video.
Sounds like I've been paid. Yeah.
All right. Keep looking, would you?
Thanks, Bobby.
Well, we're not dealing with the anti-claws.
What bugs you?
Probably morons. He also said that it was probably Meadow's reason for those reasons.
Wow. Really? What was Meadow's sweet?
It's pretty rare, and it's probably the most powerful plant in Paganmore.
Paganmore?
Yeah. See, they use Meadow's sweet for human sacrifice. It's kind of like a... chunk for the guys. Guys were drawn to it, and they'd stop by and smack on whatever was nearest human.
Why would somebody be using that for Christmas trees?
Well, it's not as crazy as it sounds, man. I mean, pretty much every Christmas tradition is pagan.
Christmas is Jesus' birthday.
No, Jesus' birthday was probably in the fall. It was actually the winter solstice festival that was co-opted by the church and renamed Christmas. But I mean, the Yule log, the tree, even Santa's red suit, that's all remnants of pagan worship.
Who knew that?
You tell me next, Mr. Bunny's Jewish? So you think we're dealing with a pagan god?
Yeah, probably Cold and Car, god of the winter solstice.
And all these Martha Stewart wannabes buying these fancy reeds.
Yeah, it's pretty much like putting a neon sign on your front door saying, come kill us.
Great.
Huh. When you sacrifice to Holding the Car, guess what he gives you in return?
Lap dances, hopefully.
Mild weather.
Kind of like no snow in the middle of December in the middle of Michigan.
Do we know how to kill it yet?
No, Bobby's working on that right now. We gotta figure out where to sell them those reeds.
You think you're selling them on purpose? Feeding the victims to this thing?
having a nightmare?
Yeah, another one.
Hey, at least I got some sleep.
You know, sooner or later we're gonna have to talk about this.
Are you here?
Yeah, welcome to Toledo, Ohio.
So what do you think really happened to this guy?
So we're gonna find out.
Reveal me to Southside Cheyenne. She's been tracking some leads. Look, I know she's not exactly on your Christmas list, but if she can help us get the Lily.
Man, work with Ruby, don't. I don't really give a rat's ass.
What's your problem?
I wouldn't want anything to do with this, and we dragged her back into it, Sam.
She knew what was at stake.
Oh, yeah, saving the world.
We're doing such a damn good job. I'm tired of burying friends. Look, we got a fresh trail. We follow it, I know. I just said I'm just getting tired. We'll get angry.
much do you think a metal sweet tooth would cost?
A couple $100 at least.
This lady's giving them away for free? Anything about that?
Pretty suspicious.
Remember that reed Dad bought on that one year?
You mean the one he stole from the liquor store?
Yeah, it was a bunch of empty beer cans. That thing was great. I bet if I looked around hard enough, I'd probably find one just like it.
Dude, what's going on with you?
What?
I mean, since when have you been crossroads? Why do you want to do Christmas so bad?
Why are you so against it?